Welcome everyone out there. My name's Heather. I'm Grandmother Florida Mayo's daughter. We have a few minutes before we get started. So take a minute. If you want to get yourselves some tea, something to drink, for those registered, and we're going to make sure that those on Facebook have it if you want to register. We are in the webinar format where you're only going to see who's speaking. And today we have Leanne Hill, who is our lead seed keeper at the PATH. And then we also have my mom, Grandmother Florida Mayo. So we are so excited that you are joining. I'm going to pause for 1 second because I am not. Let's see, I want to make sure that people are able to get on Zoom real quick with us. So, 1 moment. And let's see. Okay, I'm just taking a minute to make sure that all the registrants got the information to how to join us. And we're going to begin in about 2 minutes, right at the top of the hour. In Facebook, you guys can type in any questions that you have, and they will be sent to me. All right. And I do want to let everyone that is joining us on Zoom, we are in the webinar format again. We're going to begin in about a minute. And Facebook, if you want to send in a question, you can go ahead and type that in. And we have beautiful Valerie and her daughter Bella helping us over there with that aspect. So we have many people that are actually going to join us, probably listen to the recording. And Valerie's going to put the registration link. So if you find that you're not able to stay on Facebook, or maybe you don't have Facebook, go ahead and register and you'll get the recording. With that being said, I want to introduce my mom and Leanne, and I'm going to bring them to camera. So my mom is actually in snowy Estancia, New Mexico. I'm actually in Hawaii, but I wanted the winter landscape. And beautiful Leanne, you're in Colorado, right?
Or, yes.
Yep.
That's right. Northwest.
So it's also snowy over there too.
Very.
Yeah. So I want to go ahead and let everyone know that if you have a question, you can use the Q&A to send in something from if you're with us on Zoom, or you can use the chat button. And again, this might be a little bit different. A lot of people use the meeting format where it kind of reminds me of something from the Muppet Show where everyone, you can see everyone along the top of your screen. We choose the webinar format so it isn't as distracting. But you can still type in your question. You can send in, use your emotions. They have a little emoji where you can send hearts and stuff like that, or type in any thoughts. If you want to put where you're joining us from, you can on the chat. If you're in Facebook, welcome. We're so excited to have you. And with that being said, it's a beautiful day on the Mayan calendar, Mom, and I hoped that maybe you could talk a little bit about what you're looking forward to in 2023 and open us up with a prayer, and then we can talk a little bit about the day on the Mayan calendar, which it's 11 Ashpu, which is the day of the warrior, isn't it? I'm learning.
It's been a couple of years. Yes, you are, Heather. Yes, yeah. It's yeah. The Mayan, the calendar is really difficult. Yeah. But thank you for that. I always wait for you to let me know so that, I know that you're on with that. That's good. Yeah. Thank you.
We're always learning. So I'm going to just spotlight you, Mom, so that you could walk us into a prayer. Thank you.
Beloved beauty, beloved mother. Beloved creator of the heavens and the earth. Creator of all of the beauty that is around us. Creator of the mountains and the valleys. The oceans and the rivers, the lakes, beloved creator. The beauty of the clouds. The shores in the oceans, in the rivers, in the lakes. Beloved mother, on this sacred day of 11 Akpu, beloved beauty, you remind us that we as humans have the capacity to be the warriors of the light. And the translation of warrior within the Maya tradition, beloved beauty, you remind us that we have dreams, that we have visions, that we, each and every one of us, men and women and children, have the capacity to have that dream, to see that dream, to experience that dream, and to be able to travel out into the infinite, to grab the dream, to embrace it, and to return back into our physical form and to manifest it into a physical reality. Beloved creator, beloved mother, this is what has happened at the path, at the 40 acres. You took me out into the infinite and you gave me a mandate. You showed me dreams. You gave me a vision. And you gave me the strength to bring it all together. And in return, beloved Creator, I became a good listener and one who knows that these visions and these dreams could come to fruition. It's a sacred day today, beloved Creator, in which we honor you. On this particular time, as we come towards the end of the year, beloved Creator, as we stand here before you in this place of winter, in this place of standing still, in this place where we could dream, we could sit and we could envision, and we could hold in our hearts the impossible and dream a dream for the future generations, not only for the children, but those seed children that need protection, that need to be here for the future. Beloved Creator, I want to thank the four sacred elements of life, the earth, the sun, the fire, the air, the breath, the wind, the rain, the waters, the spirit of the Mother Earth, beloved Creator. We, as humans, cannot live without these sacred elements, and neither can the seeds. The seeds cannot grow and become what they are here to become without these elements, whether they are medicine seeds, food seeds, whether they are here to be in the form of trees, beloved Creator, all of life, all that lives, all that comes from seeds. On this sacred day, beloved Creator, I ask that we as humans have that in our hearts throughout the day, to pray for life and to pray for all of those living little children, the seeds. In the name of the great mystery, beloved Creator, I thank you.
Thank you, Mom. That was beautiful. I wanted to take a minute to introduce Leanne. She is our lead seed keeper, dear friend, and she's joining us from Colorado. And today, you know, I called the webinar Walking in Wisdom 2023 because we're coming to the end of our year. 2023, we've got some beautiful things that we're, you know, thinking about doing, Mom and myself and Leanne and the seeds. And I wanted to take a minute to have Leanne share a little bit about herself, and then also what we're looking forward to in 2023. So we're kind of excited because I feel like it's been a hard few years for everyone, and people are probably still having a hard time. And we're really looking forward to bringing in some new wisdom, some, you know, the theme of reciprocity. And I'm going to have Leanne share a little bit more about that and then come back to Mom to also share what she's looking forward to in 2023.
Thank you, Heather. Thank you, Grandmother Flor de Mayo. Beautiful prayer. And I'm feeling and sitting in that space right now. I feel like you summed up so much in that beautiful prayer. Well, the seeds are really what brought me here. Of course, as the seed keeper at the path, it's such an honor to be in that role. And I thank the seeds for that, first and foremost. And of course, I thank the path for bringing me into that space, because it is really a sacred space. I've been drawn to seeds since I was a young child, playing in the forest and wondering what those beautiful gems were. And then moving into, I guess, adulthood, I became able to work with them more directly and connect with them. And I think it's really an ancestral connection that many of us feel with these seeds, because we are seeds. We all come from seeds. And I feel like there's a place in all of us that we feel that. And probably those of you joining us today or listening and looking at this in the future have that same calling. So I did have the opportunity to work with seed keepers in northern New Mexico while I was doing some studies. And the seeds just came forth and brought me into the circle. And so I guess I'll sum it up that way of kind of my background, though I did then have an opportunity to work with and for Rocky Mountain Seed Alliance for 6 years, working so closely with seeds. And I think that was really an important part of my journey that is continuing here. And so when we talk about this year, and Heather, I don't know how deeply you want me to go right now into some of the offerings, but we are excited to share some deep offerings this year. We plan to really bring, I think, part of the theme that we're talking about, this great mystery in the darkness, and we're coming to light. Of course, it's the time of year to be reflecting in that way, but thinking about how we germinate in this darkness, I feel like it's just been a really deep awakening right now, and we're coming out collectively out of darkness and still yet into this great mystery of light and life. And that is how we are seeing the next year with our seed work. The sacred seed reciprocity is like a circle or a spiral, really. Seeds give so much, and we want to share that with everyone, with as many people, yeah, as many beings as possible through quarterly seed. We're going to have quarterly seed gatherings on Zoom with special guests to talk about seeds and just connect people. People have come to us and shared that they really need that connection. And so we want to honor that and host that. And those will be scheduled around equinox and solstice in the coming year. And so stay tuned for that. That'll be a virtual thing that everybody from all four directions can join us. And then we'll have a couple of live seed events and seed schools. So we want to invite people to New Mexico for those. And we'll see how other things that kind of unfold in this great mystery in the coming year and where the seeds guide us. We also each year share seeds to grow out so that they're coming out of the darkness into the light from their germination and their hibernation in many ways. So we bring them forth for seed seekers, seed stewards. Any level of seed seeker is invited to join us in this. And we'll have information on the website on how you can participate in helping us grow out seeds. You can return them to the past so that they can continue to be grown out. We're just really trying to keep that spiral flowing and going. And we're really excited that we can start doing that in person. I think being virtual has had its setbacks, but also it's been very positive in many ways, but we're really excited to connect.
Yeah, I'm gonna bring Mom in. Mom, I know one of the things that, you know, it's been a tough couple of years, and, you know, we're so excited that we feel like we can meet again and bring people to the path, send these seeds out. I think the other thing that we had talked about was also trying to get more medicinal seeds, right, to build that up. And I think that's really an important aspect. And Mom, maybe you can share what you're looking forward to in 2023 and the importance, you know, and of people, you know, the in-person and the ceremony and stuff like that. That would be wonderful if you could share your vision.
I think that it's really important to, finally, we have gone through this period of time, and to come together physically and to be able to look at each other, heart to heart, eyes to eyes, and to really, it's something that is really needed, amongst humans. We need that. There is a Spanish saying that says, we need the warmth of each other, And so I'm really looking forward to having the path, the 40 acres, be opened again to the community. And for everyone that can come, and I'm looking forward to the excitement of the different folks that are going to be available to do some teaching. So I'm really, really looking forward to that. And of course, for me to do some teachings on ceremony and prayer, because we have to have our prayers. There's just no way that we could keep going without engaging in prayer. So I hope to have the opportunity to do that, for me to be able to show people how to keep things in prayer.
I think that brings me to, if you haven't visited the path, it's more than just the seed temple that we have there. And I think that's, it's like a beautiful place of prayer. It's a place of pilgrimage and ceremony. We've got the temples that honor the fire. We have the wind temple. We have the water temple, which is magnificent, with the grandmother rock, and the earth temple. And with that being said, over the last few years, not having those people or the volunteers coming, it's definitely going to be something as we get closer to spring that we're going to need we're going to put a call out for specific volunteers as we get closer to what we are looking for. But one good way to stay in touch is to join our mailing list to know about those in-person events or the webinar and the Zooms. And I think that reciprocity, like Leanne was talking about, where it is almost, we were talking about the vision of that sacred spiral of us growing, and giving back and nurturing each other like a seed, and I think it's a beautiful thing. It's been, the other thing I think about as we go into 2023 is just that sense of community, and I think that really is a beautiful thing to look forward to as well. Mom, can you share a little bit about your vision when you were creating those little temples? And then I'm gonna have Leanne talk a little more specifically about the seed temple and what we've got down there and what we're looking forward to in 2023, hopefully.
This vision came to me in kind of like different segments. I don't vision things like a whole paragraph, a whole book. It doesn't happen to me like that. It happens in little, small amounts that I can process, that I can pray on, that is small. And I think that it's something that I have always put in my prayers. I always ask the Creator to have pity on me and not to give me too much to do. I always ask, to give me small projects. At least that's what I kept seeing were these small visions. The first vision was in my bedroom, And I saw these invisible white hands come through my the head of the bed, but it's really the wall, because I have a window and a wall next to my where I could see the sky. If I wake up in the middle of the night, I like to look out the window. I saw these white hands come out like that, and the invisible being said, "Come with me." And that was it. That was it. So I kind of processed that. And then the next vision was the invisible being called my name. At this time, this invisible being to me is very familiar. I understand the voice and I hear the same voice all the time. So the invisible being said to me, "Flor de Mayo." And then at that moment, I woke up, I opened my eyes, and the voice said to me, "I want you to bring people to New Mexico." As a human being, I went into my human mind and I said to the invisible voice in silence, because I have my husband sleeping next to me. I said to the invisible being, I said, "Bring people to New Mexico in this tiny little house, my little house." I was like, "What?" And so that kind of went like that. And so I'm having like this kind of like dialogue and kind of like an argument, kind of like complaining. And I learned English in New York, and it was kind of like, "Are you kidding me?" Kind of like that, you know? So I thought, and then I was like, just still. And the voice came back and said to me, "Now." And that, I was just like, whoa. It was an experience of whoa. Then that was around this period of time that I had that in 2010. And so I counted the months, January, February, April, May. And in May, this man called up at 5:30, 6 o'clock in the morning. And he was the man that was, he had bought the 40 acres, which actually had belonged to Heather and her husband, Brian. And this man had bought the property at an owner's contract. And he called me and he said to me, "Come and pick up the keys to the 40 acres. I'm leaving the state." And I said to him, "I'll be right there." So in my pajamas, I put a shawl on and I went to where he was. And he gifted me the keys and he left. And I stood there at, you know, at that early in the morning at the 40 acres. And it was like something came over me. It was like this energy of understanding came over me. And I am sitting on the porch and I'm looking at the space, and I went into prayer and I said to the beloved mother, I said, "Beloved mother, is this where you want me to bring the people to New Mexico?" And it was like this very, very beautiful very silent, kind of quiet kind of day moment in the desert. And out of nowhere, I mean, just out of nowhere, this little draft of wind came from the southwest, and it came around like that, and it kissed me on the cheek, and it almost made like a smack sound, like that. And I just like, wow. And then I thought, okay, that's a reassurance. And so I want to leave it like that. And when people come to the 40 acres and they come to visit, I have the original photograph of the little porch and the little hogan that is there. But of course, the little hogan was uninhabitable, and I had to restore it. So for those people that have come to the 40 acres, they have seen the little hogan totally restored. That would be, you know, the office room, the bathroom, shower, the kitchen was redone, and the whole area of the hogan. You know, this is the beginning, and this is like the whole meaning of today's day, that we have the capacity to receive messages from the invisible, from our ancestors, and to grab it and to move with it. Pray. I kept praying. And in the middle of all that prayer, I shared it with friends and family, my husband. And so, you know, it's a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful story behind it, and where we are right now, this very moment, coming into 2023. And so it's like 13 years ago that I started to receive these visions only about, you know, the property where the seeds are. Yeah. Thank you.
Thanks, Mom. And I'm gonna have Leanne share a little bit about the seed temple and what we've got going on over there, because it's just magnificent. The whole place is just a beautiful vision that came to life. So I'm gonna have Leanne talk a little bit more about that.
Thank you, Grandmother Flor de Mayo. Thank you for sharing your vision. Each time I hear it, I feel like I see and can go deeper into your vision. Thank you for sharing that. And I feel like a real newcomer in a lot of ways. I had been to the seed temple for a seed gathering prior to, and I don't want to put everything in the context of COVID in 2020, but I did become the seed keeper in 2020. So it has been very quiet out there. And I had only been there once before for a gathering that around winter solstice also. So it's a place of contemplation, I think, at least from my experience. And because I've been there in very kind of solitary ways since then, it is a place where we can really gather our, I don't know if I want to say thoughts, more our heart and, you know, our kind of deeper sentiments. Maybe it's more of what you're speaking of, Grandmother Flor de Mayo, just spirit. There's a place where we can really have time, space, and quiet for that. And that's been my experience. When I go to the seed temple, I'm there to be with the seeds, work with the seeds. I don't want to call it work because that's not the right word, but to just be with the seeds and ask them what they want. It's that kind of place where you can go into that contemplative space within yourself. So I go down into what I call the seed womb, not the seed room. It's underground, and the seeds really are resting right now in that space. And I can feel their energy, and that they're, you know, some of them are ready to come out, as I mentioned before, but this is where the seeds are being protected, and they're underground where they want to be, germinating in their own ways without having to grow physically right now, but these are living embryos. They're breathing, they're living, and they're waiting for their time to come forth, and the seeds find their way. That's what we've always said with seeds in the work that I have done with seeds, and the time that I've been so blessed to work with them. They find their way to the hands and the seed keepers and the seed seekers that need to find them. So the seed temple is a place where they rest and they come forth. And so through these different, we're kind of calling them initiatives, again, for lack of a better word. I feel like our language is limiting in so many ways. So I just want to hit that straight up. But the seed initiative last year, we said, well, we really want to focus on this support, being supportive of one another in this time where we're not able to reach out to each other so much. And so we did bring the three sisters forward to share last year. And what I'm starting to see, I do feel really new in this role, and so open to what unfolds and open to the great mystery of it. But we're seeing, we're building this time on last year. Certainly those seeds of the corn, beans, and squash are the ones that we have many of that have been given to the seed temple. And so we will be sharing those abundantly. And we hope to share both offer and receive. We do not have a lot of medicinal seeds, but we have a lot of requests for them. And we'd love to share those forward. So if people want to share those with us, we would love to accept them so that we can share them forward and have more seed stewards grow those out for sharing. We have a lot of really special varieties down there, ones that I'm just getting acquainted with. I think what I've learned is I've learned a couple things, that each seed is a child. I've learned this from Indigenous elders who have so graciously shared that, and Grandmother Flor de Mayo mentioned that as well, that these are our children. And so we try to treat them as such. We try to nurture and grow them when the conditions are right for them to thrive, and so that they can really offer the best of themselves, right? Just like we want to do with ourselves and with each other. So I think that's an important thing about the seed temple, is that we're really trying to bring them forward when their conditions can best support them. And I also want to mention that each seed is a prayer. When we talk about prayers, each seed we plant, we're planting a prayer of abundance that can be shared forward for future generations, you know, and we're also planting infinite possibility. Like, it's amazing what seeds are capable of. They're not just one entity, right? They're supporting a network and ecology of beings, you know, from humans well into the non-human realm, and even like supporting beyond plants, right? Water life can be supported. So all life on everywhere is supported by the seed. So we're really trying to be contemplative about where these seeds go. I think in the coming year and beyond, we'll try to do more climate matching when we can, and gathering more information from people that are offering seeds so that we can share them forward into conditions that would be conducive. And we know never to give up on a seed. If you want to grow a seed from another place that isn't really your climate match, we want to accommodate that, because I really believe, from my own work with seeds on my farm for 10 years and from my mentors who have told me never give up on a seed, that we can create these conditions as well. Sometimes, especially like think about medicinal seeds, I think we need to be thinking that way. And with changes in climate conditions and just all conditions on this planet, we can create conditions for things that we're really needing in our lives. So I went a little more esoteric on that about the seed temple, but it's all part of it to me. So I don't know. If you have questions, please put them in the chat.
Yeah. And then also, if you're on Facebook and you have a question, Valerie will send that to us. And I think one of the important things is we kind of know that next year we're going to be doing, as Leanne mentioned, these seed webinars, seed socials around the equinox and solstice time. So we'll have more information on that as it becomes available. We're also going to have an in-person event in the spring and the fall. And we're looking at kind of right at the end of April. So be on the lookout for that information. And then we're actually looking at one in the fall when there's a, I think it's a partial lunar eclipse that goes right over the path. The path is located in Estancia, New Mexico, rural New Mexico. You can fly into Albuquerque or Santa Fe. So we try to build the events in a way that it's easy to get to. So you might find that the part of the event might be in Albuquerque or Santa Fe, and then like a day trip to the path. So just to kind of look out for that. But it's pretty easy to fly into New Mexico. It's a beautiful place if you do come visit. I always encourage people, you want to have like 7-10 days if you're there. You might as well try to do the Four Corners, go to Mesa Verde, go to Chaco Canyon, visit some of the pueblos, enjoy the culture that New Mexico has to offer besides the beautiful sunshine. Mom, do you have any? Oh, and the what?
And the food that New Mexico has to offer.
Especially the green chili. So you got it. I mean, it is just an incredible place. And I know that, you know, Mom, it's been a place over there in Estancia. She's going to sneeze. It's been a place that you love living in New Mexico, and living in over there in little tiny Estancia.
Well, I think one of the huge reasons for loving New Mexico so much is it reminds me of home, frankly. Estancia is a very small community, like population 700, and the majority of the people here in Estancia are like third, fourth, fifth generation Mexico. And mm-hmm. So a lot of my neighbors, I can speak to them in Spanish. And mm-hmm. so that to me is really, really good. And we have a lot in common as far as food is concerned. And so, you know, that for me is very nurturing to be in the United States and yet at the same time to be in a place that's very similar to home. The word Estancia means a place to rest. And in Estancia, we have this beautiful, beautiful lake. And in the old days, people used to bring their, when they were traveling, going from the East Coast to the West Coast, they used to stop in Estancia to water their animals and to rest. And that's what it's called. That's why it's called Estancia. And visiting the park is quite a treat because we're in the middle of the desert and yet we have this beautiful little lake here in the little town. And I am here in New Mexico because I was brought here by spirit. And that's, I had no idea there was even like a New Mexico anywhere. I had no idea of geography. I was in the Adirondacks and, you know, just prior to coming from Central America, going into New York, and from New York, when my husband graduated from the university as a teacher, we moved to upstate New York. And the reason for upstate New York is because he loves hard winter, loves the mountains. He was just rivers and all of the outdoors he can get. That's why we were there.
That's beautiful, Mom. What are you looking forward to in 2023 as we move into a new year, Mom? Which, any prayers for or anything you're hoping for humanity?
That's a really good, interesting question. I'm gonna quote this Buddhist saying, And it's not a saying, it's a Buddhist wisdom. And the wisdom says, the trouble is you think you have time. And when I read that this morning, I thought a lot about it, that we sometimes we say to ourselves, oh, I'll take care of that tomorrow. Oh, next week I'm going to have time. Oh, next summer I'm going to take a week off and I'm going to do that next year. And the trouble with all of that is that we're all organic beings and we don't know when it is that we're not going to be here. And so, you know, today we're putting the prayer out and we're putting the vision out of saying to people, hey, come down. And for me to say, hey, you want to learn how to do prayer? You want to learn how to do ceremony? You know, commit. Because when we commit, we strive for that commitment. And we just don't know, you know, we do not know how much time we have. And so the other thing that I think about is in Spanish, we have a sound that is kind of lamenting. And the sound is, ay, it's like, ay, and ay is the sound that we make when something has gone, has disappeared. Whether it's a plant, a tree, an animal, a mountain, a river, a person, a grandmother, an elder, a priest, a grandfather, it doesn't matter. But it's the first word that comes out of, you know, if you speak Spanish, that's the first thing that comes out. It's like, ay, which means like, oh, I should have done that. I should have taken care of it. I should have, when I was invited, I should have gone. I didn't know that this would have happened. This would have happened, meaning that it is gone. And that's the wisdom that I read in the information, the magazine that I got from the Buddhist wisdom this morning. And I thought, that's so appropriate. That is so right on. And, you know, here we are on the day of the warrior, you know, the warrior of the light. And how beautiful that is, you know. So, you know, take it to heart. Don't wait, you know, don't wait, you know, because that's not the way that it is, you know. We don't know, you know, we don't know. Anyway, that's my answer.
I love that. Leanne, and I'm gonna ask you, what are you looking forward to? Or what wisdom do you hope to bring into 2023?
Do you know where I'm sitting is really back in the great mystery. I feel like, at least speaking for myself, like life's been very micromanaged. Maybe I'm just have been micromanaging it and I'm exhausted and I'm just letting go. And I think it actually reflects what you're saying, Grandmother Flor de Mayo. If we're so busy micromanaging our like next move, we're missing this moment here. I do look forward to more work with seeds, and I really believe and feel that that's happening in 2023 for me. And I hope to share that with others who are curious and interested. And so that's something I really am looking forward to. And I guess I'll leave it at that. I think those two go really well together, the darkness and the light coming together.
It's going to be beautiful. And we're getting close to near the end, and I just want to take a minute to talk about different ways to give to the path. And, you know, there's different ways, even if it's not monetarily, you know, you, and I think when we talk about this theme of reciprocity and that sacred spiral, whether you're sharing things on Facebook, you know, Mom, I think I heard you one time say, you know, be part of what you love, you know, so if it's seeds, if it's animals, you know, if it's protecting the environment, if it's, you know, wolves, you know, do something that you love, you know, whether it's sharing posts, you know, finding some wisdom about it and sharing it. And I know one thing that I do with my social media that I really had to make a point of doing is sharing positive things, filling the world with a little bit more love and light and positivity. You know, we can all go down that rabbit hole. And I think that sharing that reciprocity of wisdom keepers, elders, nonprofits that are dear to you, you know, even, you know, one thing that we do with our post, it could be finding that artwork and giving visibility and recognition to artists and stuff. So, you know, there's a lot that we can do as individuals, you know, and I think it's really important to know that we have this power within us. We can be, like Mom says, warriors of the light and spreading prayers and sending good messages into the world, I think really helps resonate. So, you know, try to follow us if you can on social media. We also join our mailing list because we're going to let you guys know when we have events going on in different ways to help us. And Kitsia mentions, may the earth bless you, may the path blossom, sending you much love from the seed bank Buena Fortuna Gardens in Baja, Mexico. Thank you for your prayers and seed preservation work. So that's beautiful.
Right, back at you, Kitsia. Blessings in your work with the seeds, and let us know what that involves and how we can connect and support one another.
Yeah, and I think that's, you know, that's it. It's about that reciprocity of, you know, giving and supporting each other. And I've included a few links, and I know on Facebook, I know that many people are going to watch this in the future. Many people are going to watch it on Facebook later on in the day or throughout the next few days. So I encourage you to take a minute, take a look at the comments and the links. For those that registered for the Zoom webinar, we'll send a handout as well. So I'm going to just take a minute and put some links in there. And I think as we get to the end, I'm going to have Mom share some final thoughts. And then Leanne's going to close us in a prayer. If we don't have any questions, I'm going to check in with Valerie if there's anything on Facebook. Mom, did you want to some final thoughts, as I think we're, what, 2 days away from the end of the year?
Yeah, we're 2 days away from the end of the year. And what I think about is how wonderful it's going to be, you know, having visitors at the 40 acres, you know, to come in and visit us at the 40 acres. And I want to mention that I'm really happy that Leanne is now living in New Mexico, which doesn't make it too far away, you know, for her to come down. And and I'm so looking forward to being with other elders, seed keepers. You know, as everybody knows, I'm not a farmer. I'm a woman of prayer. You know, that's who I am. I dream, I capture the dreams, and I bring them into reality. I mean, you know, this is who I am. But you know, I invite you to come and be here with us next year. And that's what I'm thinking. I'm just happy about that. Yeah.
Well, that makes you quite the seed keeper, because you bring these prayers of seeds into being, into the light. So thank you for that. That's the most powerful thing we do with seeds. Yeah. Well, is it too soon for the closing prayer? Do we have anything to share before that, Heather? Any questions out there?
We don't have any questions. We've had a lot of people sharing, you know, that they love what we're talking about, enjoying the conversation. So that's really sweet. So maybe we've already answered all the questions that everyone has about the path. And I think at the end of it, you know, I just want to encourage everyone to stay in touch, have a safe new year. You know, we really are looking forward to 2023. And please stay in touch. And I know sometimes we'll spontaneously do these webinars in the moment and Facebook Live. So always be on the lookout for that. We never know what the moment might be. I remember yesterday speaking to Mom, and I was like, oh, we should get on. And then I reached out to Leanne. So it's always a blessing to have those of us join us. Jessica said, hello. When will the path start to welcome guests? Thank you there for being so good to the soul to be here with you all. Mm-hmm. It's going to be at the late spring, kind of the end of April. We're looking at doing, and I'll have Leanne kind of talk a little bit more about how they do the seed school, and then we'll do an event at the path. And we're looking at a weekend, probably event, more than likely a big part of it being in Santa Fe, because it's easy to get to Santa Fe, easy to find accommodations, easy to fly into. And then it's about the same distance from Santa Fe or Albuquerque. It definitely is though something that if you're making the visit, flying in, you do want a rental car in New Mexico. it is driving, and it's worth driving around New Mexico. And I'll have Leanne kind of share a little bit more of what she envisions as we have those couple events in the spring and the fall.
Yeah, thank you. I'd love to. And I'll try to be more specific this time. So the dates that we are looking at, and I think we're settling in on this, is having the in-person event around Beltane. So May 1st, May Day. The weekend is actually the last 2 days of April. And I'm feeling like that's a good time to gather, as much as I love the idea of having the event on May 1st. The 2 days before are Saturday, Sunday. And we've invited Bill McDorman and Amigdio Bayon to join us. Now I have to actually confirm that with Amigdio yet. He's at Tezuque Pueblo. Some of you may have heard of him and his wonderful seed work, another seed elder that has so much to share. So we're hoping to bring him in. He's very close, so hopefully that will work just fine. I know he wants to work closely with us in this next year. We're all really excited to gather together around the seeds. So mark your calendars for April 29th and 30th. That's a Saturday, Sunday. And I think I have those dates right. And we would start with a seed school in a day. This is a beautiful offering that Bill McDorman and Bell Starr started when they were with Native Seed Search as co-directors. And then they were the directors of Rocky Mountain Seed Alliance, where I had the great privilege of working with them and really developing this seed school in a day, though it's a foundational, like a heartstone of sharing seed saving techniques and bringing in elders and indigenous elders to share their ways with us. And it's a full day event, kind of this really soul filling day together. And that would be, we plan on Saturday in Santa Fe, seed school in a day. And then Sunday having an event at the 40 Acres in Estancia, that Sunday having a seed share, visiting and having ceremony together to share seeds. You can participate in one or both. We'd love to have you in whatever capacity you can join us. I like, Heather, the way you've kind of presented it as, you know, it's really easy to fly into Albuquerque if you're coming from afar. Wonderful, actually, airport to fly into. Very simple. And you could kind of make this triangle from Albuquerque to Santa Fe, Estancia back to Albuquerque. It'd be a really beautiful loop for folks that haven't, or triangle, and just a really wonderful time together. So that's 29th and 30th of April. Love to
and
see.
And then the next one we're looking at would be at the end of, well, it's kind of the middle of October. There's actually an eclipse right over the path on October 14th. So probably around that time we're looking at. That's actually a Saturday, October 14th. And then, of course, our online will be around the equinox and solstice. So we'll be coordinating that with more people. And we always try to make it available that there is a registration fee because there are costs associated with it. But we always try to have a scholarship available. So know that we always have, student, senior, and scholarship. So all you have to do is reach out. Even on anything that we do that might be a webinar where we have a nominal fee, we know that it has been really challenging for a lot of people. So always know that if it's something that we're putting on, to reach out and ask, and I would encourage you to do that.
Absolutely. We plan on having a sliding scale. If you have a little extra you can share to help support the scholarships, that can be included in the sliding scale if you're able to be on that side of it. Either side, we never would turn anyone down. So again, don't ever let that dissuade you, any kind of costs or prices. We welcome everyone.
Well, and I think that's the nice thing about, too, having events in New Mexico, because there's so much camping. If you are in that situation where you want to also be in nature, there's some beautiful places to camp. It's always sunny in New Mexico, even though it's a little snowy right now where you are, Mom. You've been having a little bit of the cold weather having come from Hawaii. So but it's still sunny out there, it's just beautiful. So, and it is, I have a whole little list. If you're thinking of coming to New Mexico, I have a list of must-sees, beautiful hikes. I mean, it is just one of the most beautiful places to be. I really, it's just, I can't say enough about it. With that being said, it is the end of the year. And if you are in a place where you're looking at making an end of the year tax donation, we'd love if you would consider it for the path, or like Mom says, something that you love. Because many small nonprofits, they do struggle and rely upon your donations. So with that being said, I think we could go into prayer and close it out and look forward to seeing everyone in 2023.
Thank you. Thank you all for joining us now and later and into the future. As I close this in prayer, I'd like you to just envision a seed or a plant in your hand, and let's pray together in connection with bringing forth life from the darkness. I give thanks to the Great Spirit, the Great Mother, the Four Directions, all of the beautiful entities that bring forth life, that bring us all from darkness into light. And I give thanks, so much gratitude for the great unknown that is going to be around us as we spring this life force forward into the coming year. May it be with abundance, with kindness, with generosity for everything, all the gifts that everyone offers into this world. And I just really pray that we can do this together and join together to make the next year one full of beauty and growth, abundance and appreciation for the reciprocity of seeds and the sacred spiral of life. Thank you so much for being here today, and many blessings in this year to come.
Thank you, Leanne. Thank you, Mom. And thank you, everyone, joining us. And we look forward to seeing you in New Mexico and online. Many blessings. Bye.